Good morning, Stratford. I'm Ben Bexley.
And I'm Zane Arell. Today is Friday, March 6th. It's an F day, only 21 days until spring break.
Today's weather forecast calls for sunny with gusty winds this afternoon and a high of 59 degrees.
Happy birthday to senior Andrew Dells.
Today is Dentist Day, Employee Appreciation Day, and National Frozen Food Day.
Here's Haley Ellison with today's lunch menu.
Today in the Prentice Robinson Cafeteria, we have roast pork loin, baked apples, chicken tenders, rice pilaf, steamed lima beans, steamed green beans, roasted vegetables, and penne marinara. Reporting from the gazebo, Haley Ellison.
Ms. Ferrari is in the studio with an announcement.
Good morning, Upper School. This is Mrs. Ferrari with some reminders about the Technology Code of Conduct. One, all non-educational games are off limits on computers that are used on campus. Two, non-educational videos are not to be streamed or watched during school hours. Three, social networking sites may be blocked on campus at the school's discretion. Four, to protect the users of the internet on campus, many sites have been blocked. The use of any means, including a VPN, to get around blocked sites is a severe infraction of our code of conduct. And five, the use of the internet is a privilege, not a right, and inappropriate use may result in cancellation of those privileges. Finally, upper school students may use their cell phones during break or lunch. Now, here's an example of the technology code of conduct that you've read it for. This is Will Deal's form. He signed it, and so did his mother's, saying he would abide by all of the rules that are in here. Signed off on it. Now, at my request, Stratford's IT department is monitoring student internet use, and at my request, blocking students who are using it in a way that is not in compliance with our technology code of conduct. If you have been blocked, you will need to see either Mr. Calais or me to discuss having your access reinstated. So in sum, there are no rights being violated here. Other than at break or lunch, the school day is not the time to be watching movies or fooling around on social media. Period. Now I have one other brief warning. There seems to be a strange bright yellow ball in the sky this morning, so you may find that you need to use these. Have a wonderful day, Eagles.
For the next 2 weeks, a summary of new course offerings will be featured at the end of Good Morning Stratford. At the conclusion of today's announcement, humanities teacher Dr. Tom Lewis and theater director Ms. Sylvia Haney will talk about their upcoming semester classes, film and literature, and dramatic literature.
Student Leadership Board applications are on the student portal titled SLB Applications 2020. All students in grade 9 through 11 are encouraged to apply. To run for student body president, you must be a rising senior and must have been on SLB in the past. Applications are due next Wednesday. If you have any questions, see Ms. Peterson, Mr. O'Hara, or Mr. Calais, or any other SLB representative.
There will be a Writers Club meeting today during break in room 121. The Writers Club is holding a book drive from March 9th through 17th. The donated books and cash donations are instead of admission tickets to the talent show. Each student is asked to bring a brand new child's book for pre-K to 12-year-olds or $6 to your homeroom. Please remember, it must be a brand new book. Proceeds benefit the Ronald McDonald House, and the homeroom with the most donations will be rewarded.
There will be a meeting for seniors in the Beta Club today during break in Mr. Etheridge Room 123.
A representative from Covenant College will be in the boardroom today during break.
Be sure to vote in today's poll at StraffordGazebo.com. What is your opinion on daylight savings time?
Remember, set your clock 1 hour forward on Saturday night.
Have a wonderful day, Eagles.
Hello. We're here today to introduce a brand new course that will be taught next year at Stratford called
Dramatic Literature.
And it will be an interdisciplinary course, which means that we'll be attentive to both literary analysis and performance. We will be spanning the ages, looking at ancient Greek drama, Renaissance drama,
dramatic literature.
We'll also be looking at the 18th and 19th centuries, and we will be looking at modern drama and looking at a number of very influential contemporary plays in a class called
Dramatic Literature.
So we strongly recommend you take this class, and don't forget the title is
Dramatic Literature.